My name is Agnisha Jayaprakash, founder and director of Agni's Ignite. Thank you so much, members of the jury, for selecting me for the third round of the World TV show. Today, I'm going to be starting off with the idea, the inspiration of my idea, and the current status. Agni's Ignite was launched in 2014, and it was inspired by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who was a former president of the country who tragically passed away in 2015. He wanted to stop the brain drain which was occurring in the country. What we did with the Agni's Ignite was we went on a statewide talent hunt throughout 5,000 schools in Tamil Nadu. This was in association with the state government of Tamil Nadu as well as the United Nations India. What we wanted to accomplish was to showcase these young talented scientific minds who had the entrepreneurial spirit in a television platform over the first ever science reality TV show titled Era Marivu, which is showcased on Doordarshan Podige from 7:30 to 8 o'clock Monday to Friday now. Currently, we are serving as an incubator for these 120 startups. We have established industry ties with several chambers of commerce and industry such as FICCI, New Delhi, amassed partnerships with over 120 industries who will manufacture these startups in a large scale, and also structured tie-ups with foreign universities who are interested to fund these young student projects. Currently, in Agni's Ignite, our incubation center has finalized 250 promising startups. Each of these 250 startups has been subjected to feasibility study and ease of implementation studies and have been screened over from 1.3 lakh applications from across Tamil Nadu. So, suffice to say that we have chosen the best startups which have the most chances of success and funding when it comes to projecting these ideas to angel investors and venture capitalists. We will promote and showcase these 250 startups to angel investors and venture capitalists for funding. We will hold 20% stake in each of the successful startup which secures funding. For the startups that do not secure funding, we will still keep trying to get them funds. An example of these successful startups which are at advanced stages of funding and valuation are as follows. The first one is a microbial fuel cell which converts cow dung into electricity. It was valued at $1.2 million by Boeing, which has reached advanced levels of talks in terms of funding. The other company is Garuda Aerospace, which is an unmanned aerial vehicle and drones company, which is into aerial mapping and video surveillance for government projects. It was valued by 10 crores by companies in Singapore and Denmark. There are several other projects which are in advanced levels of funding talks, and we would secure 20% of stake in each one of these companies, and that is how I will make Ignite a successful incubator in the future. I'm going to talk about my team structure and background. At the top of my structure is the board of advisors. I've been fortunate to have been advised and guided by 25 eminent personalities, scientists, chartered accountants, bureaucrats, and people from the funding agencies. My board of advisors include Dr. Rajiv Chandran, United Nations Information Center, New Delhi, Dr. Salim Ali, ex-CBI, Dr. Kiran Bedi, ma'am, LG Puducherry, and Mr. Munir Oda, former Chief Secretary of State IAS, among others. Supported by these advisors, I am backed with a core team focused in operations, marketing, and finance who have had over 20 years of experience in their respective fields. But my biggest strength is my 40-strong field team who go out there every single day wanting to make Ignite the best startup in the country. In terms of funding, with the current set of enterprising ideas and innovative startups in hand, we have already set up meetings with venture capitalists and angel investors and are in talks for funds of over 20 crores. With 2 years of experience, we are confident of expanding our operational geography throughout India. In the next 2 years, we aim to partner with the Government of India in its various initiatives like Startup India and Make in India and make Ignite a pan-India initiative. What Why do I need the funding? With the mission that I've embarked on the Ignite journey in executing these startups and attracting angel investors and venture capitalists, a recognition from the Walt Show and ET Now would give me a huge stamp of credibility and also a tremendous encouragement for all those young budding entrepreneurs who are waiting to see the light at the end of the tunnel.